The fence outside the King Soopers in Boulder, Colorado has grown into a memorial that is home to thousands of items that have been left there since a shooting at the store in March left 10 people dead. Starting this week, the Museum of Boulder will preserve as many items as possible. Mark Salinger shows us the wall has become part of the history of Boulder.
It started as a fence surrounding a tragedy.
Very quickly became a site of sort of communal mourning and grief, but also reflection and healing.
The flowers, the notes, the faces.
Things like this are left by kids are really, really powerful.
And the names of the 10 lives lost on March 22nd.
It really feels like a privilege to be taking care of the stories like this.
It's Chelsea Pennington Hahn's job to make sure the wall is remembered.
Yep.
Even after it's taken down this week.
When the shooting happened, we, you know, knew really quickly that this was a part of Boulder's history. And
Pennington Hahn is the curator of collections for the Museum of Boulder. She walks down the wall, preserving the items left by the community.
Basically everything we can, we'll save.
Nearly every day since that horrific afternoon when a grocery store parking lot turned into a memorial.
You see the outpouring of their grief, of their, you know, their wishes for change. It's just such a raw sight of that emotion.
The items left on the wall will be preserved by the museum and eventually displayed to the public.
And there's a huge like range of objects and type of things.
So
they have left a sort of child
shopping cart with flowers, and then
Officer Tally.
For more than 2 months, the wall has helped the town heal.
You know, it's devastating, but it's still important to preserve it. We can't just ignore it and, you know, wish that it never happened and not think about it. It's still important to tell that story.
Now, it will forever be a part of what makes Boulder, Boulder.